Welcome to the 8th edition of World Intellectual Property Forum. The inaugural ceremony will be starting in few minutes.
Distinguished participants and experts, ladies and gentlemen, greetings to you all. I am thankful to the organizers of the World IP Forum 2020 for inviting me to share my thoughts with you at this prestigious event. I congratulate them for organizing this important forum in a virtual setting without diluting its content and the level of expert participation. Today, I would like to speak to you on the role of intellectual property during COVID-19 times and its relevance for economic revival package, keeping in view the goal of Atmanirbhar Bharat. The COVID-19 pandemic, which is confronting India and the entire world, has had a massive impact on global and national healthcare systems and medical infrastructure, resulting in significant economic downturn in world economies. The emerging scenario has also brought to the fore the indispensable role and significance of intellectual property and innovation. What are the IP implications in the COVID-19 times and post-COVID? How can countries and enterprises utilize intellectual property for economic revival? I would like to briefly highlight 6 major imperatives of intellectual property as they concern the present crisis. Firstly, IP will continue to play an important role during the pandemic because innovation and creativity, catalyzed by intellectual property, pervade all fields of economic activity and endeavor, and therefore may be regarded as a relevant policy tool and strategy to combat the challenges of COVID-19 pandemic, as well as to reignite the flame of economic growth. It has been noted during the previous global economic downturns that countries and businesses which continue to innovate and generate new ideas within the constraints imposed by the global crisis are able to withstand the economic shocks better and are able to bounce back and resume productive activities earlier. I would commend this approach to all industries and businesses to reflect and rethink innovative ways of doing business in their future continuity plans and to generate IP assets for an Atmanirbhar Bharat. There are enough indications and examples that the present epidemic has forced governments, corporates, including MSMEs and startups, research labs and academia to think out of box and find innovative and affordable solutions to manufacturing, testing, and treatment. Indigenously developed Covaxin, which is ready for emergency approval, is a befitting example of India-led innovation. Indian startups have played a stellar role in building up Indian capabilities. Government of India has already come out with elaborate fiscal and banking packages, incentives, and relief for incentivizing research investment, and production in priority sectors. Secondly, let me address the question whether intellectual property rights could pose an obstacle to supply of IP-protected drugs, products, equipment, and testing, or hinder access to education, research, and culture that are essential as countries fight against COVID-19. As you are aware, the Indian IP laws are post-TRIPS vintage and are fully compliant with India's international obligations. Available flexibilities have been judiciously invoked along with providing specific provisions to safeguard against any national emergency such as COVID-19. The Supreme Court has upheld provisions relating to compulsory license in the only one instance when it was allowed. It has also upheld Section 3D of the Patent Act against evergreening of patents. While India has been extra careful about invoking compulsory licensing provisions, many countries have recently empowered themselves to issue compulsory licensing. The fair deal provisions and the compulsory licensing provisions under the Indian copyright legislation for enabling teaching, research, education are considered as adequate for meeting the urgent needs. While we need to exercise vigilance and caution, much will depend upon the attitude of IPR holders, who are expected to take a humane and cooperative view during this crisis. Thirdly, the Indian IP laws and the National IP Policy of 2016 have provided a solid foundation for the future development of IP in India. However, in my view, both the laws and the policy need to be kept under scrutiny. The IP laws, for any revision needed, keeping in view national interest, and for enactment of new laws in certain areas, such as trade secret, public funded research, and traditional knowledge. And the IP policy for an evaluation of the pace and scope of implementation and identification of any gaps which may be perceived, for example, in the area of digitalization and new and disruptive technologies. Fourthly, international cooperation will be crucial to successfully fighting the pandemic and the post-pandemic phase. The Secretary General of UN has launched the UN Comprehensive Response to COVID-19. The Directors General of three world organizations, WIPO, WHO, WTO, have released a new trilateral study regarding the intersection between public health, IP, and trade within the broad perspectives established. These organizations have been requested to encourage all their member states to take advantage of flexibilities in the international system that permit use of IP-protected works for online education, teaching, research, and experimental uses, including for text and data mining and artificial intelligence projects, and for public, vital public interests, such as access to medicine and culture. The WHO has been called upon to create a global pool of rights in COVID-19 related to technology and data. India and South Africa have moved a resolution in WTO for a waiver of certain IP rights during the pandemic. WIPO has developed tools and conducted research to assist scientists, researchers, and policymakers in finding solutions to the challenges posed by COVID-19. Fifthly, there is a real problem involving IPRs, which tends to magnify in times of such national emergencies, the problem of counterfeiting, piracy, and illicit trade. The shortage of medicines, medical equipment, test kits, and essential consumer goods encourage production and supply of fake and spurious medicines and products, which compromise consumer safety, suppresses genuine economic activity, results in job losses, and erodes tax revenue. There is also greater incidence of online piracy and cyber crimes. While consumer awareness and stakeholders' vigilance are necessary to combat these crimes, the laws must be fully invoked and enforced against such anti-national activities, which are very detrimental to the cause of Atmanirbhar Bharat. Finally, let me commend the proactive activities and actions taken by IP Office and IPAB to keep the wheels of administration moving through recourse to the digital medium and providing necessary relaxations and relief to applicants. A similar approach has been adopted by the courts in the process of adjudication. Allow me to indicate certain priorities and recommendations for further improving IP ecosystem in India, keeping in view the goal of Atmanirbhar Bharat. I have already touched upon the need for evaluation of the IPR policy. The second point that I would like to say that there is a need for a comprehensive baseline survey or IP audit across important sectors of the industry and economic activity. The IPR policy recommends this. It will be possible to frame a tailor-made and sector-specific IP strategy for each of these sectors. This would enable promotion of domestic innovation and IP asset creation and would help build local, regional, and global supply value chains, which are very essential in this time. There is also a recommendation for India to undertake an impact study for copyright industries based on internationally accepted guidelines, which measures the impact of copyright industries on GDP, employment, exports, etc. This needs to be done soonest as the contribution of the creative sector in a country like India is sizable and robust. Similar studies should be commissioned for technology and other IP protected sectors. I need not belabor the importance of IP awareness for all the sections of the society. The government's efforts in this regard should be stepped up by various sections of the society and all the stakeholders. Intellectual property as a subject should become an integral part of India's educational curricula, starting from school level. Continued modernization of IP offices, focusing on efficiency, quality, and service orientation, following the best practices in the world, is necessary in order to make Indian IPO count as one of the best managed offices in the world. As far as IP enforcement is concerned, apart from all the action that is being taken, we have perceived the need for a central coordination empowered body for effective interdepartmental collaboration with countrywide jurisdiction capable of a unified view. And this would be a very desirable step as we go forward. Like apex level institutions for other sectors of national importance, an institution for IPR development and research needs to be established in order to harness the full potential of IPRs for economic growth. This is essential to develop an interdisciplinary pool of IPR professionals and experts in spheres such as policy and law, strategy, development, administration, and enforcement. The Union Budget 2020 has favored establishing such an IP center. Finally, the management and new and disruptive technologies needs to be focused upon. Artificial intelligence, blockchain, Internet of Things, virtual reality, and other innovations of the 21st century need to be protected with power of ideas and exploited and managed for the benefit of the society. Simultaneously, the IP implications of these technologies related developments need to be thoroughly studied for a balanced and harmonious evolution of IP laws and regulations in the future. In conclusion, therefore, IP-led innovation will continue to be relevant both for combating the COVID pandemic and for accelerating engines of economic growth. International, institutional, industry, research and development, and academia cooperation and partnership will be crucial, particularly in the medical and health sectors, as well as other dynamic sectors of the economy, to create an Atmanirbhar environment. Strengthening and modernizing the IP system and building an IP-stimulated innovation ecosystem should remain high on the priority list of India. I wish this event, this forum, all success, and I thank you for your attention.